Okay, this is a quick lesson in how to play The Stumble by Peter Green, as played in John Mayall's Blues Breakers. I'll play it through once as it is, and then I'll just break down the various sections. And I'm only doing the first part of the song, so here we go. Okay, so let's start off with the first part. The first riff is... Just put a tiny bit of vibrato on the last note. You don't need to overdo it and give it a heavy metal thing, so just do it nice and gently. So your first riff. Then your second riff. Just do that again. Okay, now I'll do it nice and slow. The key one for me, the key note, is that sort of second to last note. You go, just bend it up slightly as you're playing it, so. And then we get this a nice little seventh chord there. So it goes. Then it repeats the first lick again. And those stabbing chords there is dead simple. It's just really an A7 chord. So it's the A note, C sharp, with a G. You can play it like, I play it with my little finger there. You can play it with your third if you like. I think little finger's easier. And it's kind of a couple of stabs, really. And then it finishes the phrase off like this. Again, it's that little second to last note that it slightly bends up, and then just to finish. So I just do that again. Okay, so we'll do it up to that point. Now for this next bit, I like to play that. It's an E note, but I like to play the E on the fifth string on the on the second string on the fifth fret plus the open E. I think you just get that sort of a country type feel. Just listen. So you see what I mean? Instead of playing, you go. So I'll do that riff again. Okay, and the next bit's quite tricky. Okay, so that's slide, it's basically over a, this is over an A7 chord, so if you can think of an A shape, that kind of A shape, and then the tricky bit is he does a kind of a... So you think of it in triplets. So I'll play the full riff. And then the very tricky bit, which is the double stops here, which go, I'll play them real slow to start with. There's different ways of playing it. I kind of play it here because I think it's easier to get to. So you'll start there, it's your 12th fret basically. That was a bit ropey, actually. I'll try that again a bit slower for you. Okay, so for the very last riff on that first bit, I'm just going to change around a little bit here and show you what my fingers are doing. So I actually pick this and keep some open notes going to go. And if you can see that. So that's going B flat to B, open E. And then you go B flat, A, G. And then back to that low E. So you can think of this one riff, two riffs, then. E, D, B, E, D. So,